something that is not, I mean, sometimes we cannot stop things from happening because the time, well, the time has come, it's right. Because again, through education that you see that all, because through education that you see all these things are happening, right? It is not logical that generations of people have studied in the United States in Western countries, and it is true the introduction to democratic ideals. Just look at yourself, right? Your experience here. You know, how much have you learned about the life of the Americans and also the ideals and the reality of things here that have changed your perception of what you thought of America when you were in the country? And how much is it in your classroom, for example? What is valued in your classroom? Is it the exchange of ideas or the suppression of ideas? Right? In my classes, what I would look for students who are very critical, who can challenge and argue and challenge each other and challenge me and challenge other classmates. The A student is one who is always critical of things. Right? And this is what we want to see, critical thinking. Without critical thinking, you know, it's difficult for the country to move because we will always be subjected to the bodies of knowledge that have been passed down to us, that has been packaged, that has been, you know, produced by those who have the means to produce. And education has so many different angles. I will stop after this. Education has different dimensions. When you talk about education, what is it? The process of education means the process of drawing out potentials, educare, from the Latin word. When you want to draw out the potentials of each and every child, because the child is taken from the natural environment, the natural self, natural rights, you put the child in school, the schooling itself is not neutral. Schooling is very ideological. You put the child in school for many years, you can put anything. It all depends on the ideology of the state. A child in a communist country will be produced as a communist, and if he or she does well in school, you know what they will give? The best student, A student, want to get 12 A in a bust of Lenin. Vladimir Lenin's, you know, it's like a child in Islamic country will have a different, this is the thing, because again, like I say, back to the original statement, right? Culture is not in the tools that we use, it's not in the skills and habits that we acquire, but it's in also everything in the house that we inhabit. Right? So that's the process. You can create, take children, take human being, and put them and to become technologists, you can put them to become, you know, philosophers, you can put them to become social scientists. But the process of human capital is not to capitalize on the human being so that he will become big capitalist and control everything, but to have the human being become a human being that can look at the plight of others. Doesn't matter whether what race of people are, but the person with the human heart who will use his or her knowledge for the benefit of society, because society needs to be renewed all the time. Generation after generation need to be renewed, right? We must continue to think not as a communalistic, but as a cosmopolitan human being. Be able to look at perspective. Because we do not have perspective, we are trapped in this dynamics of race. Not just race, but ultimately it is a class system that is we are confronted with. Class of people who are laborers, international class of people, children, people who are only producing for the world economy, whereas the world economy is controlled by 2%. America is controlled by 2% of its people. 98% of wealth of America is controlled by 2% of its. The Vanderbilts, the old money and the new money. Now, do we want to transform this ideology of political economy to the country? And if it's really transformed, you know, it will become another America, America of the 55th state, for example. We have all the inherit all the maladies, and we are looking at more stratification in terms of class, race, and everything. And where is this going? we are entering dangerous zone. We are living in very interesting times. But if you apply theory of chaos, complexity theory, everything is can be applied to that. Chaos, final words. Complexity and chaos theory says that when an organism, something happens in one place, then started changing the dynamics. For example, if a butterfly flaps its wings in the Amazon 20 years ago, the wings, I mean the motion from the butterfly can create ripples and create hurricanes 20 years after that because dynamics. And look at society, look at what's happening in your country from that point of view, then your mind will be better trained to analyze. And not just to that, but to go beyond that and to find solutions. We don't live in this world alone. We are a social being, right? I want to thank you for being more and more confused. And I hope that, you know, it makes sense. Probably in the other sessions or conversations, we can continue to exchange points of view. And I hope you enjoy speakers, I mean, the lectures from other speakers. Thank you so much.